Kung mag-start out ka, first you consider, aside from your capital, kasi malaking capital investment, the place, siyempre, you have to check it with the local government unit. Kasi there are zoning classifications that would prevent you sometimes from putting a poultry farm in that particular area. The business was started by my father, late father. Late 70s, he started it out. He rented out farms. Sa Rodriguez, Rizal, that area. Rodriguez and Mateo, ayan. Kasi it used, that place used to be talagang punong-puno ng farms. Yan. Ngayon, medyo nabawasan. He built it little by little, just increasing the capacity, number of birds na alagaan niya. And then, he mixed his own feed then para mas maging matipid and mas efficient yung production. Slowly but surely, na-build niya yung company. Before, it was just a single proprietorship. So, ngayon, we registered it na sa company. Sa time ng dad ko, the biggest poultry house nun, mga 4,000 heads lang. So from 4,000 na nag-rent out, and then now we have on our own place, mga more or less, pag pinagsama-sama mo lahat siya, the two farms nasa 40,000 to 50,000 heads. Kung mag-start out ka, first you consider, aside from your capital, kasi malaking capital investment, the place, siyempre, you have to check it with the local government unit. Kasi there are zoning classifications that would prevent you sometimes from putting a poultry farm in that particular area. So, if your area that you're looking into, pwede mag-poultry or hindi. That's number one. Kasi, pag hindi ka pwede doon, and then tinuloy mo pa rin, makapalisin ka, hindi mo pa nire-recoup yung investment mo, palisin ka na. Yeah, so once you get the local permits, merong national permits. But the national permits, pwede ka kasing yung tinatawag nilang ECC from the DNR, Environmental Compliance Certificate. If you are raising below, I think 10,000 at that, you can get an exemption. 10,000 hens. But above that, you need to get an ECC. And then if you're in the Rizal area, Calabar Zone, I think Taguig din ata. You need to get an LLDA clearance, Laguna Lake Development Authority clearance. And then merong isa pa, license to operate. That's from the Bureau of Animal Industry naman. So, they'll check your farm and then give you an LTO license to operate. Okay, so once you have that, how big is your space? Let's say, sa 1 hectare, you can put 3 buildings na 6,000 capacity. So, sa about 18 to 20,000 kaya. Sa 1 hectare. So that's 3 buildings na yung properly spaced na siya. Kasi you have to allot for pagpasok ng trucks, hauling trucks. So, this is roughly 8,000 square meters. Yung kung saan nakatayo yung poultry farm. 8,000 square meters. So you can go even as low as 8,000. Pero 1 hectare, yeah, maganda. Mas maganda kung 1 hectare para may maganda yung spacing mo. And pwede mong lakihan ng konti yung building. Tapos may you have room for expansion din if eventually na gusto mong magdagdag. And then you have to check yung property you're looking into. Siyempre, yung shape ng lot. So, dapat mas maganda rin na medyo patag siya. Kasi yung pagpasok ng delivery trucks mo, pagpasok ng hauling trucks mo, syempre kung matarik siya, mahirapan, magiging challenging for your viajeros, baka hindi na sila bumalik. So, you have to look into that. The ideal capacity is parang kasi per building and per poultry flockman, parang 6,000 to 8,000 heads kaya ng isang laborer, isang poultry flockman. That's the parang ideal ratio. So he'll be in charge of feeding, ganon, providing the water, ganyan. Pagka naging automated ka, so mas pwedeng mas marami. Automated yung feeding and drinking, mas pwedeng mas marami lagaan. You need to consider kasi where will you market. For example, sa area mo, ganito lang population. So, huwag ka masyadong mag-alaga ng marami. Kasi most likely, you have to haul it somewhere else. Sell it somewhere else. That's the ideal situation na you sell locally para minimal ang ano mo, ang overhead expenses mo. Ang hirap kasing sabihin na with this much amount of chickens, you'll get this much income. Number one kasi, if you're in a commercial operation, you cannot dictate the price. Commercial operation na small to medium scale, classified as small to medium scale. Kasi ang nagdi-dictate ng price is usually the ones who have the volume. So, bigger companies. So, kung sino may volume, siya yung nagdi-dictate ng price. Tapos, your production cost depends a lot on the quality of your inputs. Kung pangit sisiyo mo, problema yon. Kung pangit feeds mo, that's another thing to consider. Number one, of course, huwag mong titipirin yung feeds. Dapat maganda talaga feeds mo. Kasi yung iba, dito na ako sa mura. But yung grow time mo, mas mahaba. And mas marami siyang kakainin para ma-reach niya yung weight na gusto mo. So, ayan. So, feeds and then get good quality day-old chicks. And isa pa, you should check on what your market or your potential market needs in terms of the size of your chicken.